Hello, hello, hello. Today is Monday, May 16, 2022. It's early in the morning for me, maybe not for you. Solutions of problem 143. Before I tell you about the solutions, of course, I went up in the middle of the night and I looked in the south, into the direction south, about 58 degrees, 55 degrees above the horizon, and I saw mostly clouds. Occasionally, I could peek through the clouds and I saw one or two stars, but I never saw the moon. I was in my house in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Had I been in my house in Coventry, Connecticut, the situation would not have been any better. But of course, I have seen pictures sent to me during total lunar eclipse, and they were stunning, really stunning. So, solutions to problem 143. Key is that you watch lecture 12 of 801. If you've done that, the answer to problem 143 is totally trivial. Read with me. The viscous storm will dominate when the terminal velocity is much smaller than the critical velocity. I mentioned in lecture 12 that the critical velocity is C1 divided by C2 times R. When the viscous term dominates, as I mentioned in that lecture, the terminal velocity is mg divided by C1r. The mass of the oil drop is given by 4/3 pi r cubed times rho. It is assumed here that the very small size of the water drop still remains spherical. So, since V term has to be much smaller than V critical, this has to be much smaller than that, and it means R has to be much smaller than that. Not very intuitive, isn't it? 3 1 squared divided by 4 pi rho g C2 and the whole thing to the power 1/3. All right, physics is not always intuitive. Have a nice day and take care. And if you have seen beautiful total eclipse of the moon, try to send me some pictures in YouTube. That is possible.